Welcome back to TekMinded. In today's tutorial, we'll be diving deep into principal component analysis, PCA, using the scikit-learn library. We'll explore the concepts, step-by-step implementation, and practical examples to help you grasp PCA thoroughly. So, let's get started. Before we jump into the code, let's take a moment to understand what PCA is all about. Principal component analysis is a dimensionality reduction technique used to discover patterns and relationships within high-dimensional datasets. It accomplishes this by transforming the data into a new set of variables called principal components. These components capture the maximum amount of variance present in the data. All right, let's dive into the code. We'll start by importing the necessary libraries. Great! Now that we have our libraries imported, let's load the dataset we'll be working with. For this tutorial, we'll use the famous iris dataset, which contains measurements of iris flowers. It's a well-known dataset with four features: sepal length, sepal width, petal length, and petal width. Our goal is to classify iris flowers into three species: setosa, versicolor, and virginica. Excellent! We have successfully loaded our dataset into variables x and y. Now let's perform PCA on the dataset. We'll create an instance of the PCA class and fit it to our data. Perfect! We have performed PCA on our dataset, and the transformed data is stored in the variable x_PCA. Now let's explore the explained variances and cumulative explained variances to gain insights into the significance of each principal component. In this code snippet, we calculated the explained variances and cumulative explained variances using the explained underscore variance underscore ratio underscore attribute provided by the PCA object. We then plotted them using a line plot. The x-axis represents the number of components, while the y-axis represents the variance explained. Looking at the plot, we can observe how each additional component contributes to the explained variance. The explained variance line indicates the individual variance explained by each component, while the cumulative explained variance line represents the accumulated variance explained by the components. The cumulative line provides insights into how much of the total variance is captured as we increase the number of components. Now that we have a good understanding of the explained variances, let's take a closer look at the transformed data. We'll create a scatter plot to visualize the iris flowers in the reduced dimensional space. In this code snippet, we used the transformed data x_PCA to create a scatter plot. Each point represents an iris flower, and the color indicates its species. By visualizing the transformed data, we can see how PCA has compressed the high-dimensional iris dataset into a 2D space while preserving the discriminative information. PCA is not only useful for visualization, but also for dimensionality reduction. We can choose to keep a specific number of principal components that retain most of the variance while reducing the dimensionality of the data. For example, let's say we want to reduce the dimensionality of the iris dataset to only two principal components. We can achieve this by modifying our PCA initialization as follows. By specifying an underscore components equal sign 2, we restrict the PCA transformation to retain only the first two principal components. This reduction can be handy when working with large datasets or preparing data for machine learning algorithms. And that wraps up our tutorial on principal component analysis using scikit-learn. We covered loading the dataset, performing PCA, exploring explained variances and cumulative variances, and visualizing the transformed data. The complete code used in this tutorial can be found in the description below. Feel free to experiment with different datasets, component selections, and explore the numerous applications of PCA. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to our channel for more exciting tutorials on data science and technology. If you have any questions or suggestions for future tutorials, please leave them in the comments section below. Thanks for joining me today on TekMinded. Stay curious, keep exploring, and I'll see you in the next video.